Okay, nice to see you again. I want to talk something very important in this video. I want to pour my heart out. Especially, I'm pouring my heart out, for my people, for my Igbo people, for my fellow Igbo people, because I came from Igbo, the tribe in Igbo land, the tribe in Nigeria called Igbo, Biafra. Biafra land. I want to use this opportunity to pour my heart out. You have to listen very careful before you say anything or before you comment. You have to listen first. I was born into this world. As I came into this world, I find myself as a Nigerian. I was born in Nigeria. And I was born in Enugu State. I came from Nigeria, Enugu State. And Enugu is Biafra land. Let me say it's like the headquarter of Biafra land. But yes, my father, he told us a story. We hear the story about the war, Biafra war, that happened before we were born. My dad told me how many Igbo people that were slaughtered, how many Igbos that were slaughtered during this war. So we hear the story. So as we are growing, one time ago, Wazbike started the issue of Biafra. He called it Masop. He called it Masop. So he started the issue, and he was creating awareness, to everybody, that Biafra must come, Biafra must come. So my dad also joined. My dad is a priest, he's a reverend. My father loved the idea, was going for the meeting. Every time they come meeting, we attend the meeting with his brother, his late brother. In fact, they carried it, they carried it on their head. It was too much. My dad keep going anytime they say, come to Abakariki, come for meeting, another one, or Okiwe, where they have Mr. Okiwe, that they should be coming. My father, every time, keep going, keep attending the meeting. Every time they tell him, say, give money. Even they later make him, they made him, they say, okay, he's going to be the reverend or a priest for Biafra. My father, as I'm talking to you, this happened between 2005 to 2010. My dad keep attending, and they gave him, said that he's one in charge of prayer, reverend for Biafra. So my father keep giving, going every time. All the money I'm giving to him, he's giving it to Biafra to see that Biafra actualized. So one time my father told me that he was telling me what's going on there. They say Obama is signing the paper now. Many times my father said that they said Obama is sitting down, Obama is signing the paper now, that the Biafra will be announced tomorrow. Every day, different story. Every day, different story. So many times they went for a meeting. Obasanjo will send the Nigerian army to block them, to arrest them, put them in prison. So many times they kill so many Igbos. At Okigwe, they slaughter at as many that they want. They will kill them. So many times my father escaped from being arrested. When time he comes back, I said, Dad, you have to stop going to this meeting. Because I'm not seeing what they are saying. I didn't see truth. I see Yahoo Yahoo in the system. So many times they came to our compound, they'll be smoking their hemp, they will be doing all kind of all manner of tens, charms. I say, is it how they will actualize the Biafra? They will come, they will tell my friend to bring something that somebody is coming from Kibwe, to come and collect money from them. They will gather money, food, everything. They will carry and move. One time I look at my father and say, this is Yahoo Yahoo. They are doing you people Yahoo Yahoo in the name of Biafra. One time they told my father to go and sell something to take. But if you have yam or you have rice, go and sell it in the local market, in our village market, that they will sell it and they will get the pounds, Biafra pounds. I say, for what? To do what? you know, Biafra is not yet, you have not yet come. Why would they tell people to go and sell something in the market to bring home pounds, Biafra pounds? Where are you going to spend it? So one time they told them to begin to put a flag in the compound. So many, it's not what I will talk, I will say. It's not what I will talk here. So many times, my father, we travel to Okigwe, coming back, all his money is finished. He said that they pay for this, they pay for that, they do for this, they do for that. And they told them that tomorrow they should be listening to the radio, that Obama is signing the paper now, that tomorrow they will announce Biafra. At the end of the day, nothing. So many lives was slaughtered, was killed during this was week of attempt during his time of saying that he wanted to actualize Biafra. And I understand that this Biafra, Ojukwu started it. Ojukwu ended this Biafra halfway. He ran to Ivory Coast. So many lives was slaughtered. So many Igbo life was given to Nigerian demon, Nigerian python, Nigerian devil. They keep feeding Nigerian demons with the blood of Igbos. During the time of Ojukwu, so many blood was given to Nigeria Satan, Nigeria demon. He drank and get drunk from the blood of my fellow Igbo people during Ojukwu issue with Nigerian government over the actualization of Biafra. After that, Ojukwu did not achieve it. Ojukwu came back and contested for presidency under Nigeria, the same Nigeria that you fought war, that you engaged in war for your people to be free. You came back under APGA and contested for presidency before he later died. And the same Nigeria paid him millions for being ex-army of Nigeria. They paid him pension, they paid him millions. They paid him millions, which I'm sure of. He didn't talk about Biafra again. He didn't say anything about Biafra again. He collected the millions, contested the presidency under APGA. After everything ended, Wazirike started give his own life to Nigerian python, Nigerian devil. He gave to as many in the name of Biafra, pump the life of innocent Igbo people, the poor youths. Ignorant is a disease. He pumped to as many he can pump. Today, the same Wazirike is with Nigerian government, with Nigerian authority. He closed his mouth. He's no more talking about what's going on in Nigeria. I know how many people that died during his own agitation, his own time of trying to actualize Biafra. So many people died under Wazirike of Eten. Then now he closes his mouth. He have taken his own share and closes his mouth. Now Nnamdi Kanu, spring up, started making a wave. The whole universe, I supported him. I like Nnamdi Kanu. I like him so much. But a lot happened again. So many lives were slaughtered that Jubilee sent down to Nnamdi Kanu, home. So many lives that was slaughtered, that was killed. They feed the python, they call it Operation Python Dance. They feed also the python, two-way python. They feed the Nigerian python again. Nigerian python suck the life of youths again. As men that they want to suck, they suck their life again and do like nothing happens. In the name of our same Biafra, will everybody die before this Biafra will be actualized? Before this Biafra will manifest. Will everybody die? I want to advise my fellow Igbo people, this is not the way to actualize Biafra. Barcelona, you know, in Spain, have been fighting for their independence for how many years? They are going to court. They are doing it. Even Guardiola, the coach of Manchester City, so many times he will make a comment and the football governing body, they are against him because all of them in unison, they are working to see that Catalonia become independent. They are busy going to court. They are busy working it out. They are busy going underground. No life, you know, is destroyed. No life is taken. No life is being slaughtered. They are busy going to court, working it out. But my fellow Igbo people is the one fighting for Biafra, fighting that Biafra will not stand, that Biafra will not come. They are the one that is in power, you know, in Nigeria, government, eating money, having their own share, enjoying the best of the best. They don't want to know how it is going for other people. And you are telling me that this Biafra of an international community will not even come inside. Because if you want Biafra to stand, first of all, you must denounce, we must say we don't want their currency. And we must say we don't want to vote. Anything about Nigeria, we don't want to participate in voting. If we stop using their currency, stop voting, stop participating in anything called Nigeria, and someone like maybe Ike Ekweremadu and the P2B and the many of them, I'm just talking many of them that is like Ngige, all of them, they said, no, we don't want to continue in this thing called Nigeria. International community, we listen to us fast. They will come for our rescue. They will come and say, what can we do to see this thing happen? But when these people are busy fighting it, as long as they are busy fighting it, it will happen. With God, all things are possible. But I want to say something. Let us stop pumping, giving the blood of Igbo youths to Nigerian Satan, to Nigerian Python. We have fed this python enough. Let Nigerian youth be wise. Let us be wise. Enough of giving your life to Nigerian python. It's my advice. What Nnamdi Kanu is doing right now, let him keep on doing it like that. Let him keep on doing it on the ground. But let no life be lost again. Let no life be given to Nigerian python again. You are seeing it, outside people, they know politics very, very well. Yorubas know, they know politics very, very well. They know that we Igbos, we don't respect authority, we don't respect each other, all we respect is money. You say, okay, one person come out to contest for presidency now. 100 Igbo men will come out and begin to face each other. That's what Obasanjo said, I know them very, very well. I'll just tell them, say, bring one person, bring somebody that we come and the contest of presidency. Let us pick one person. The person said that if they say so, 100 Igbo men will come out and begin to face each other, then they'll just keep them one corner and move forward. They know. We don't respect each other. We are the enemy of ourselves. We are the one fighting Biafra. We are the one against Biafra. How can Biafra come? How can the Biafra come? How can? But I want to appeal that we should stop this issue of giving the life of youth to Nigerian demon, to Nigerian Satan, to Nigerian Python. Enough. P2B is now standing at the back of an awesome man. Of an awesome man. He is now standing at the back. Anytime they want to, they know Igbos very well. They go and pick them as vice, pick them to stand at their back. They go and pick them. All they know how to do is just pick one Igbo man, just pick him, and they will stand at your back. They will just follow you immediately. Because they don't trust us. But we don't want to prove them that we know what they know, that we are capable, that we are somebody. Instead, we always choose to stand at their back. At the same time, you are shouting, Biafra, Biafra, Biafra. How can it come? Please, I want to say something. Enough. Let us, if we want Biafra, everybody must say no to anything called Nigeria. Then international community will come for our aid. Or if we don't want to say no to anything called Nigeria, let all of us close our mouth and belong to Nigeria and be Nigeria we are. And let us stop lying and deceiving ourselves. You can't be in two places at the time. You can't serve two masters. You can't be serving devil and say you're serving God. Either you're serving God and leave devil alone, or you're serving devil and leave God alone. Are we Biafra or are we Nigeria? I don't understand. Some say we are Biafra. Some say we are Nigeria. But our conduct, the conduct of the big men, the people that we are looking up to, that they have a say, they belong to Nigeria. How can we do it? How can we do it? The people that are supposed to talk, to speak, the people that are supposed to say that enough of all the evil and wickedness that we are seeing Nigeria people giving to our people, giving to Igbos, enough. They did not say enough. They say that it is okay, that they like it. So what are we saying? I had a revelation about Biafra. I had a revelation, and the percentage of this Biafra being a reality is too poor. The percentage of this Biafra becoming a reality is very poor. That's why I don't like to talk. All this why I don't want to talk. I'm just looking because I'm tired. I know what I saw, what I experienced one-on-one during the time of Wazirike. And I know how many lives that was taken, that was destroyed. And you know, life doesn't have duplicates. Once it is destroyed, once that life is gone, it's gone. I know how many lives that is gone, that is taken away during the time of Wazirike. I know also how many lives that was taken away during this Nnamdi Kanu with Nigerian government in his hometown. I know how many lives that was taken away, that was slaughtered. For how long? Let us not talk about the time of Ojukwu. We will always hit it and run. Ojukwu hit it and run. They did not finish it. He left it halfway. Wazirike come, hit and run, left it halfway. Nnamdi Kanu, hit it also. It from too much. He moved to Israel. So many lives is taken away. I'm not against that, but let us try to use another method. Enough of supplying blood to Nigerian people. This is all that I want to say. I love my people. I love Igbo land. I love Biafra land. I love everybody. I wish we have to be alive to enjoy the Biafra, to enjoy it as a nation. If it happened, all of us will not die. Will not die. If all of us die, so which, you know, which means there's nothing like who will be the Biafra. Who will be the Biafra is just a name. The people is the Biafra. We are the Biafra. So we all will not die before it happens. So this is my humble advice. Please let us use another method, another style, another pattern to approach this Biafra. Enough of all this. Enough of slaughtering and killing innocent people, giving the life of the youth to Nigerian python. All right, so I want to say, as you hear this, please meditate on it. It's important. We all need to be wise, in the way we are approaching the Biafra, for Biafra to come and for all of us to enjoy it. God bless you all so much.